March 20, 2016. Walking back from breakfast with Caroline and we stopped for iced tea. A fan stopped me on Decatur and said that she recognized me. I asked where she was from, she said, "Don't worry, not planet crazy." I said, "Then where are you from?" She said, "In Denver, Colorado." I asked if she was involved with anyone, and she said no. I said, "That's sad, I've been playing Denver for over 2 decades, and I never met a person in my life in there who wasn't in a relationship." She said I was right and that she moved there a few weeks ago, and everyone she's met so far is coupled up, but she's still getting to know Denver, Colorado. I said, "Well, you're young." She said, "Not that young, I'm 31. I said, "Like I said, you're young." I introduced her to Caroline, and she said she heard her name in a lot of my songs many times. She was polite and kind and not intrusive. I asked her what brought her to New Orleans, and she said she was on a road trip and it was a good stop down from Texas. I was just in Texas too, but I didn't mention it. I just said, "Ah, oh, that's cool." Some good things come from Texas, like Daniel Johnston and the Butthole Surfers. Best thing to come out of Texas was Jack Johnson, the boxer. No, not the surfer musician. I'm talking about the first black heavyweight champion. The turn of the century fighter who had more balls than China has plates. More balls than me or you or anyone listening to this piece of music currently living in the United States. When he went to Australia, he didn't have the luxury of complaining that it took 18 hours by flight. He didn't even complain that by boat it took maybe 60 days and nights. He fought his rounds, came back with a heavyweight title. There's a great book on him by Teresa Runstedler. And even now I'm dedicated to him by Miles Davis. I'm just back from Texas, where I played a South by Southwest showcase. And here's what people said to me. "Hey Mark, did you hear that David Bowie liked your music? Hey Mark, how come you only get to play for 40 minutes? Hey Mark, I came all the way from Ireland. Hey Mark, why is the show delayed 2 hours? Hey Mark, when is Universal Themes coming out on vinyl? Hey Mark, when is Jesu Son Kim Moon coming out on vinyl? Hey Mark, is Steve Shelley playing drums with you tonight? Hey Mark, how's South by Southwest treating you so far? Hey Mark, you gonna be in Roadies? Hey Mark, when are you gonna play South Carolina? Hey Mark, you're really getting Chakra. Are you friends with Jason Schwartz? Hey Mark, did you get to meet Steve Martin? Hey Mark, when's your next move? Hey Mark, I'm taking my present. Hey Mark, what are you gonna do after the show? Hey Mark, you wanna play this song? Hey Mark, is Mark really talented? Hey Mark, are you gonna play this song? Hey Mark, you're gonna play this song? Hey Mark, just copy my demo. Ask all the questions you want to, and I'll be polite. But I'm thinking, fuck you, 90% of the time. Not a harsh type of fuck you, just a light little, I don't want to talk about me. Please tell me a little about you, fuck you. But a drunk approached me and said, "Mark, I don't know you. But you know me, I mean, you think you know me. You think you know me, I mean, you think you know me. I was like, what was that all about? She was original, that's for sure. There's some original shit that happens out there in the rock and roll jungle. Like I was in bed with these two gothy girls once after a show in Florida. When I got to piss, I came back and they were putting their clothes on really fast, all nervous and freaking out. I was like, where are you going? And they said, there are four of us in here. I said, what are you talking about, four of us? They said, trust us, there are four of us in here, Mark, and we're leaving. I was standing there naked and they ran past me and opened the door and I was saying, where in the fuck are you guys going? They rushed out and I was standing there, feeling very, very alone and all shaken up. Then I was looking under the bed and in the shower and even out the window for this fourth person. I didn't see anyone. Those chicks scared the hell out of me. 4 a.m. March 21st, my stomach's been hurting from all the red meat in Texas, so tonight we went strictly vegan. We ate at a Vietnamese restaurant down on Magazine. And during our walk there, a friend texted me. He said, hey, I'm in New Zealand. I said, hey, I'm in New Orleans. And we started texting like a couple of kids about making music together and the cost of touring. And blah, 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 blah. And starting boxing gym. But when I texted him a few days later and said that they were playing his music in a restaurant, he didn't reply. He probably thought, fuck you. Not a harsh fuck you, but the kind of fuck you I mentioned earlier. He's like me, not one to bask in hearing about people hearing his music in a restaurant. What do you even say to that? Wow, man, cool. I love to hear about myself. Send me some more. Some of us are in it for the ego stroke, and some of us are in this racket because it's in our blood and we have no choice. Caroline and I came back and I took a hot bath and I worked on the credits for the Sing's Favorites album. March 27, 2016, C-14D, United Airlines, Cleveland. To SFO, we ate in Akron last night with my mother and her boyfriend and friends. It was a very short trip to Ohio. But overall peaceful, and I got to surprise a friend with a brand new TV and some money in the form of a check. And though she was very tired, I convinced her to take a walk around the block, which I think did her some good, as she'd been so down on her luck. But I did funny little dances in her living room to entertain her and played her some music from my Sing's Favorites album. She wasn't impressed. I said, Mark, these songs sound too much like the originals. I said, that's the whole point, that it's for moms and dads and little kids and the whole family. And she said, well, did you sing my favorite song, Float On by Modest Mouse? I said, I did. She'd have to wait her hour. Look, on life seems to be getting bleaker and bleaker and bleaker and bleaker and bleaker. I wanted to give her something to look forward to in the future. Ben was nice enough to give us a ride to the Cleveland airport and do a quick photo shoot with me at the airport hotel. When we arrived at the Sheraton last night, I needed a promotional photo for the Sing's Favorites album. Caroline and I fell asleep watching the movie Spotlight about lawsuits brought against the Catholic Church for priests molesting children. It was an insightful movie about how a child can be manipulated into being molested. about how it can all start with a dirty joke and escalate into other things that I won't say. I can't be 100% sure, but I think I met a few child predators in my day. Nothing I can quite bet 100% on, but where, in my opinion, the writing was on the wall. Paper. I disassociate myself from people like that. Rank child molesters as the lowest form of humanity in the world, along with mass murderers and terrorists. I'm not a perfect human, and I'm on no superiority trip, but there's a disgusting side of humanity in that movie, and a few things that I've seen in my life made me hate the fucking world. Just for a little while, yeah, that's right. While I watched that movie, I hated the fucking world. Yeah, life can be tough if my friend isn't well. She's downward mentally, spiritually, and physically, and I'm trying to do what I can to help. My father made a comment, accentuate the positive, eliminate the negative. I'm good at that, but there are negative forces out there that are hard to prevent. They can sneak up on us out of nowhere. It's hard to ignore that shit. How can we not care? I gotta ask you something. Do you attract obsessives? I'm just curious, like when you have interactions with people, do they make mental notes or even written notes of everything you say? I mean, every little thing that you say. Maybe you know what I'm talking about here. And if you don't, I mean this sincerely. Enjoy that part of your life. Do people discuss you as a human, or do people discuss you as a product? I'm a human to most people who know me, but I fall under the product category for the most part, a target. I was born to be a product. Yeah, I'm used to that. You want to hate on me? Then hate on me. You got shit to throw at me? Then throw it. You want to punch me in the face? I'm easy to find. Throw the fucking punch. See if you can catch me. Either way, I love you. I really do. I got a lot of love in my heart. I got love for the haters. I even got love for the alligators. Blackened alligator. Oh man, it's the fucking best. This life's a rack of what I trained to when I dreamed of since I was 5. For anything else, who knows? But maybe 9 to 5. It's so bad you get to come home every day to your wife and say, hey, did you see the news? Johnny Depp's having a hell of a time. 3/29/2016, 12:31 a.m. I'm tired, I woke up in Carolinas and had trouble getting out of bed. Thoughts of Ohio overwhelmed my head. Lost the walk from Carolina's place in Telegraph Hill to my place at the top of Knob Hill. Sadly, Volcano won't be in Trieste anymore. And now Dodge Caroline's own apartment reminds me when we first got together after I knocked on her door. When I got up, made her bed, and headed up the hill. Stopped at Molinar's at 11 a.m. and got the Joe's special. Fuck a wheat bread, I fucking hate wheat bread. Trust me, you'll be eating boring stuff too when you're pushing 50, unless you wanna be dead. I came home with my apartment that hasn't been cleaned since last year. I picked up something here and there. A keyboard is coming over to my room for a summer tour. I went to deposit checks and the one from New York looked like it had been pulled out of a sewer.
may tell her she still accepted it. A friend once told me that a check that I sent him disintegrated because it was in his wallet too long, and I thought it was bullshit, and it made me laugh. But fuck, here I was with a $12,000 check that was torn in half.
I couldn't stop thinking of my sick friend. I was so distracted that I ended up leaving my wallet behind at a bank. A security guard was chasing me and yelling my name. Was I being arrested for something? What could it be? A wallet was handed to me by a security guard who didn't resemble any cast members of the Beverly Hillbillies. I'll just say that. She had a really tough look, but she was polite and had a nice smile once I got closer. I ate ramen alone, and on the way out, the kid working there asked me why I bought so many bottles of water. I didn't want to explain to a millennial that I had a 12-hour rehearsal the next day, as it would provoke more disingenuous questions. The place had just opened, and he was clearly being told to be extra friendly to customers as some kind of shtick to bring in more business. I'm gonna get my water elsewhere next time. I came home and thoughts of Ohio were still bothering me, so I created soap operas on my flip phone with a few friends to distract myself. Caroline and I met for Chinese, but we took the night off from each other, as I was so drained. We slept at our own places. The TV's on, but it's turned down. My apartment's a fucking mess. I unfolded a piece of paper that sat there forever, and a pile of hotel and restaurant receipts from Europe and Asia. It was a note from someone. Something someone handed me on tour. You wanna know what it said? Fuck you.